friends, fellow members of It's a Mug's Game. All these Friday nights, it's just a Mug's Game. From the moment that you're born until the instant that you're dead, all your picnics on the lawn and all your exercise in bed, is just a Mug's Game. It's just a Mug's Game. Yeah, you sit in the pub at nine and you're looking for a route, but you'll leave alone when it closes and stash some titties in the booth. That's a Mug's Game. It's just a Mug's Game. Yeah, you sit in the pub at nine and you're looking for a route, but all you ever get's a net where some drunk hits you in the booth. That's a Mug's Game. It's just a Mug's Game. I know, because I've been mugged. Johnny Leopard's been mugged. Places by smiling girls with pretty faces, I've been mugged. Too many girls have been mugged. Too many times in too many places by pretty boys with smiling faces, they've been mugged. We've been mugged, you and me's been mugged, cause my eyes weren't white, bright enough, but my jeans weren't white, tight enough, and I didn't do the disco duck, I was mugged. Oh, too straight for the hips, too hip for the straights. Born into the suburban middle class in the early 1950s. Why didn't my parents take me aside? Say, Dave, there's more to this world than passing your exams, being what you are. You've got to learn to play the game. Why didn't they take me aside and tell me that knowledge? Then I wouldn't have gone to the football or the cricket and been who I was. No, then I would have gone surfing like Zongo. A typical Australian beach. I'm struggling out of the surf, panting heavily from my overweight. Two young, nubile women on the beach. Oh, wasn't he spunky? Oh, which one? That one in the lyrics. No, not him. That one over there with the earring in his ear. Oh, and the bleach blonde hair, that's Zongo. Oh, Zongo.
Zongo.
Go over and talk to him. Okay. Hi, Zongo.
Hi, girl.
How are you, Zongo?
Oh, far out.
What have you been doing with yourself lately, Zongo?
Oh, I've just been having an insane time. Hey, look, that's Rory. Hey, look, oh, Rory couldn't get away with his child. I've been having an insane time. Last night, I went out to the drive-ins to see Kung Fu Fighting. And we drank two bottles of tequila and got really smashed. It was insane.
Oh, isn't he spunky? Wife and I have been like that. No, whenever I had tequila, I could only stand about three glasses. Then I could never remember whether to bite the lemon before you had the salt or vice versa. Never a success. But then again, maybe I could have been like Robert. Robert's father is an American consul in Australia. His mother is a French novelist.
Robert spends 6 months of the year up in Bali getting his head together and just, you know, working things out in his own words. Tonight we descend on Zongo in his Carlton terraced house. For those people in WA, it's say Subiaco, and for those people in Sydney, Paddington. Say, Rob, this is really nice furniture you've got here. Yes, it's, I picked it up at the antique shop down the road and he sent me back $600. Now, what are you doing with yourself these days? I'm writing a new play. It's a new denunciation of the rat race of capitalist society. Well, that's a very nice painting. Is that original? Yeah, it's only cost me $500. Hey, say, Robert, I hear that, you know where to get some stuff. Well, I do know where I could get my hands on some. How much? Oh, $50 a stick. Fine, I'll take it. Now, about that capitalist society, yeah. Mike and I have been like Robert. Read Lord of the Rings and, you know, acted really cool. Never hated anybody. Thought everybody who went to the football was a mug, you know. Or knew everybody who went to the football was a mug. Mike and I have been like that. Most of all, why couldn't I have been like Derek? Derek has got a Dennis Woolley mustache. On Saturdays he goes hang gliding, Sundays water skiing in the summer. But tonight is Friday night and Derek is going to the nightclub to score. Derek has got a Celica. Next year it'll be a BMW. He's a sales rep. Derek looks 32, though he's only 27, and he's trying to look 21. He knows the bouncers by their first name at all the nightclubs in Australia. He still pays his $5, but he has the satisfaction of calling them by their first name. Hi, Bill. Hi, Derek. $5. Thanks, Tar Bill. Tonight, in his quest for action, Derek sees in the corner of his eye Sandra. Sandra, 22, doctor's receptionist. She's got all the latest gear on. Oh, oh, as Derek walks in the door, Sandra says to her friend Marie, isn't he spunky? Derek says to himself, I think I might go after this piece. Hi there, girls. Like a dance? Oh, thank you. My name's Derek. My name's Sandra. Little do they realise that their paths almost crossed earlier that Saturday morning. Sorry, it's Friday, isn't it? Well, the Saturday morning previous, when they were both down at the boutique, he in one side and she in the other of the unisex. Yeah, that's another thing. I'm always really embarrassed when I go into those boutique things to change. I've got to get my jeans caught in, my pants, you know, my shoes and all this sort of stuff. Not Derek. Boy, he slips those things down. Just a little bit tighter. Just a little bit tighter. Oh, I think this neckline, do you think it shows enough of my bust? Yes, I think it's fine, Sandra. Okay. So they dance and sweat and dance. Each too cool to look at one another until that moment comes when they're caught under the revolving silver ball. Now Derek looks at Sandra, she looks at him. Sandra.
Yes?
Look, I bet a lot of guys have told you this.
What?
That you're beautiful.
Well, I have actually.
Well, look, I'm not going to deny that I'm attracted to you. I find you really attractive. But even though I've only known you 3 minutes, I feel this incredible bond between us.
So do I.
I bet you're a Sagittarian.
I'm a Leo, actually. I knew you're either a Leo or a Sagittarian.
What are you? I bet you're not a Virgo.
Oh, Derek.
They sweat and dance to another LRB number. And then, listen, could I take you out sometime?
Oh, that'd be lovely.
Right, well, look, listen to this one, men. But if I have to go right now, I couldn't give you a lift home, could I, girls?
Well, actually, I'm supposed to be getting a lift home with my friend Marie, but I can't see her anywhere. Well, maybe we should go. Oh, I don't know whether I should do. Come on. All right. Oh, Derek's on the way! Isn't he spunky?
Isn't she sexy?
All the way home. In the Celica. The radio on. Hey, why don't you come back to my place first for a cup of coffee? Oh, all right. Percolated, of course. Oh, percolated. Derek's thinking, I'll take you back to my place. Open the door of the Celica. We'll go up to my bachelor flat. We'll go up to his bachelor flat. I'll dim the lights. He'll dim the lights. She loves me. I love him. Maybe in a few years we can raise kids. Maybe. But first, I'll put on a little River Band record. Maybe a bit of the Eagles. Do you like the Eagles? Oh, I love the Eagles. They're so talented, right? We could put them on. I could lead you to my new waterbed. Oh, Derek, I could rip your new jeans that you bought in the boutique. Oh, Derek, I could rip yours. Oh, Sandra. Oh, Derek, I could fuck you. From society, cause our genes weren't quite right. No longer, no more. All I want is to be respected for who I am, and for you to be respected for who you are. No BGs, no Wella hair shampoo, no thick throwaway razors. I'm waiting for the day when the Derricks and Roberts and Sandras of this world, they will be on the outside. They will be condemned to an eternity of Australian Friday nights. No one has a mug's game. It's a mug's game. Cause you think you found a true love, another kindred soul. It turns out that your true love is just another mole. You got a girl at Christmas, you lost her by New Year. The worst part is she's ripped off and made off your beer. That's a mug's game. Just a mug's game. Mug's game. Mug's game. We'll have a short little...